Hello everybody, today we are going to discuss about bar graphs. Already we have seen this type in class 8, class 7, okay. So just we will put a glance with the help of one example, okay. So example is given, the following data on the number of girls to the nearest 10 per 1000 boys in different section of the society is given below, okay. Sections are given and number of girls per 1000 of boys, okay, per 1000 of boys, that is given. Now first one is scheduled caste SC 940, scheduled tribe 970, non SC ST 920, backward districts 950, non backward district 920, rural 930, urban 910, okay. And question is, represent the information above by a bar graph. Okay, and second question is, write two conclusions you can arrive at from the graph with justification. Okay, so this problem is from NCERT book. Okay, so we will see one how to construct bar graph. Okay, already you all are knowing that. Once again we are going to see. Understood? To construct bar graph we must have two axes, x axis and y axis. Okay, so with the help of scale we need to decide that x axis and y axis. Okay, so here I am taking this x axis, this is y axis, and horizontal axis is known as x axis. Okay, so now here first we need to think about the scale on the y axis. Here see, 940, 970, 920, 950, 20, 30 and 10. Okay, so minimum is 910 and maximum is 970. So we need to spread our scales according to this. Okay, so first we can write here, suppose this will be 900. This will be 900. This first line is 900 we will take. Okay, so next will be 910. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70, or we can do like this also, 910, 920, 930, 940, 950, 960 and 970. Okay, this will come on the y-axis. Okay, and now on x-axis we need to take this sections, schedule caste, schedule tribe, non-ST. These sections are given, that we will take on the x-axis. Okay, so the width of that we need to take uniform width. Okay, means bar means what? Bar of uniform width we need to take. Okay, so here we can take first is scheduled caste. So here if I will take scheduled caste, scheduled caste, then the next one is scheduled tribe. Okay, so this will come here, scheduled tribe, or here suppose I will take scheduled tribe 1 2 3 1 2 3, then next one will come here 1 2 3, it is going to come here. Okay, how many sections are there? There are seven sections, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so we have seven sections now. So we can give here name scheduled caste. So here we can write scheduled caste, scheduled tribe. Okay, next is non SCST, non-backward districts, and rural and urban. Last one is urban. Okay, so like that we have taken on the x-axis. Getting everybody? This is x-axis, this is the origin, this is on y-axis. On y-axis what we have taken? number of girls per 1000 boys. Okay, so now we need to do, this is very simple graph, already you all are knowing. So here first one is, first reading is 940, scheduled cast is 940, so 940 is here, 940 is here. So we can, with the help of scale, 940 will come here. Okay, so this is first reading. You can shade or you can keep as it is, no problem. Then scheduled tribe is 970. 970 will be here. Okay, so we need to use that. The breadth of the bar we need to keep same. Okay, next 920 will come here. 920, next one is 950 is here. Then 920, again 920, two times it is, so it will come like this. Okay, then 930 will be here, and last one is 910 is here. Okay, hence our bar graph is ready now. Okay, these are bars, these are known as bars. Okay, this is very simple graphical method. Okay, now two questions they have asked us, represent the information above by a bar graph. So this is ready. Now second question is, write two conclusions you can arrive at from the graph with justification. Okay, so if you'll observe this, so here see, scheduled tribe this is 970. Okay, so what we can write from the graph, we find that number of girls to the nearest 10 per 1000 boys are maximum in scheduled tribe. Okay, whereas as the minimum in, where is minimum in urban. Understood? So this is the different basic. This is the maximum number of girls are here, and here minimum number of girls. So we can understand from this graph. Okay, so this is known as bar graph. Okay, so see carefully and solve this in your notebook. Hello everybody, now we are going to think about the histogram. Okay, already you have seen in class 8 what is histogram. Once again we will see with the help of one example. Okay, so what is mean by histogram? Histogram is a graphical representation of a grouped frequency distribution. Okay, with continuous classes should be continuous. It consists of set of rectangles having their heights proportional to the class frequencies of equal class intervals. Okay, so see here, one example is given here. The daily earnings of 50 workers as given below. Daily earning is given and number of workers are given. Two columns are given. Here classes are given 125 to 134, two, number of workers are 2, 135 to 144, number of workers are 7, 145 to 154, number of workers are 10, 155 to 164, number of workers are 15, 164 to 174, 10, 175 to 184, 6. Okay, like that intervals and number of workers are given, and instruction is given, draw a histogram. Okay, if you'll observe these classes, the classes are not continuous. Okay, so first we need to make it continue. Understood? So how to make it continue? We need to find out height. Okay, height of the interval. So height, how to find out height, will be here 135 minus 134, means lower limit of next class minus upper limit of previous class, exactly previous upper limit of previous class. Okay, so what is lower limit of next class? Any we can take, any two interval, consecutive intervals we can choose. Understood? So 134 and here 135, so we can take here 135 minus 130. 135 is the lower limit of 135. If we have taken, then we need to take 134. Okay, previous class upper limit. So 134. Understood. So what is the difference between this one? Okay, so we need to divide this h. This is the value of h. So h is equal to 1. So we need to find out h by 2. We need to find out h by 2. So what is h by 2? 1 by 2. That is 0.5. 0.5 is h by 2. Okay, so this, why we have taken this h by 2? Here see, we need to make class intervals continuous. Okay, so here this is first interval lower limit and this is upper limit. Okay, so we need to subtract this 0.5. how we got 0.5? that we have seen. So this 0.5 we need to subtract from lower limit. Okay, so 125 minus 0.5, it will be 124.5, and we need to add the same 0.5 here in the upper limit of each class. So 134 plus 0.5 will be 135.5. okay, so this will be your first class, first interval. Now the same thing, 135 is there, we need to subtract 0.5, that is h by 2, we need to subtract from this. So 135 minus 0.5 will be 134.5, and it will come here. We need to add 144 plus 0.5 means 144.5. okay, so like that we have to do continuous. Understood. So see here, 135.5 and here 134.5 and here also 134.5. okay, here 134 is there, so 134 point plus 0.5 is 134.5, and here also lower limit is 134.5. okay, now see 144.5, here what is lower limit? 145. So we need to subtract 0.5 from this, so it will come 144.5, and here 154 plus 0.5 means 154.5. okay, so now see, the classes are continuous. Like that, all the interval classes will be continuous. So that is our first duty. If classes are not given continuous, then we need to make it continue, then only we can draw histogram. Okay, because you have seen, histogram is, you will get the bars like this, it will be completely attached. Okay, like that you will get. Understood. So there is means no gap in between two bars. Okay, so like that histogram we need to construct. So here we have done classes continuous. Understood. So accordingly we will use on the graph paper. Okay, so now here I am doing this. What we will do, daily earnings. First I need to prepare here daily earnings. Just now we have taken daily earnings, now new it will come. Now we are going to use this. Okay, 124.5 to 134.5, 130. This you need to complete, you need to write in the answer. This is the part of answer. Okay, so from this we need to prepare this table once again with continued classes, and then this we will use on the graph. Okay, so now here we need to do again x-axis and y-axis, same procedure like bar graph. Okay, x-axis, well this is y-axis, and we will use here x-axis. According to the information we need to spread our graph. Okay, so now see here, what is given here, this is going to come same 2 7 10 15 10 and 6. Okay, so here maximum number, greatest number is 15 and minimum is 2. Minimum is 2. So we can start this from 0 also. Okay, so suppose we will take here 0. We will take here 0, then 0, 2. Then here it will come 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 and 16. Okay, this is y-axis. Then 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 and 16. This is y-axis, this is origin. Okay, now this information, daily earnings, continued classes, we will put on the x-axis. Okay, but it will start from 124.5. Understood, 124.5. So directly we cannot take 125 because here we have taken 0. Okay, here we have to take 0. So now we need to take their zigzag line. or wink, kink or kink also we can say. So this shows that we can hear some readings are there, or here from 0 it will start, but according to our need we will start from 124.5 to 134.5. understood? So that I am taking now here, here it will be 124.5, okay, and here we will take 134.5. now classes will be continued. Okay, then next after 134.5 what is going to come? 144.5. so it will come here 144.5, then 154.5, 154.5, then 164.5, 164.5, then 174.5, 174.5, okay, 174.5, and last one will come 184.5, 184.5. understood? So these are our classes. Got everybody? This is important. Afterwards we can construct the histogram very easily. See what we have done. First we have to find out height of the given data. How to find out height? Upper limit of the second class or next class minus lower limit of the next class minus upper limit of the previous class. Okay, whatever difference you will get, here difference was 1, so 1 divided by 2 means h divided by 2, so that 0.5. okay, so 0.5 we need to subtract from the lower limit and 0.5 we need to add in the upper limit of each interval. Okay, so you will get the classes continuous. So now our classes are continuous. Now just we have to construct their histogram. Okay, so what is first one? This is first one, 2. So it will, here it will come 2. So this is the first class, 2, we need to join it. Next is next reading is 7 7 10 15. 7 is here, so 7 will come here, so we will join this. Okay, then next one is 10 10 will come, 10 is here, so we will join them. Okay, then next 15 15 is here, okay, then next is after 15 10, once again 10, so it will come 10, and last one is 6 6 is here. Okay, so 6 is here. So here our histogram is ready now. Understood? Here what we have taken, daily earnings, okay, on this side, and here we have taken number of workers. So here we can give name for the axis, number of workers. Okay, so here our histogram is ready now. Understood? What we have learned here, we have to make the classes continuous. Okay, one more example we will see. That is, see here, construct a histogram from the following distribution of total marks obtained by 65 students of 9th class in half yearly examination. Okay, now what is given? Marks, midpoints are given, 75 80 85 90 95 100. Here intervals are not given, midpoints are given, so we need to convert into continuous intervals. Okay, number of students are given, 7 11 25 13 6 and 3, that is given. Okay, so now what we need to do, as usual we need to find out h by 2. What is our target? h by 2. Okay, so first h, what is h? We need to subtract this 80 minus 75. Okay, what is 80 minus 75? 5. H is 5. We have to find out h by 2. H by 2 is equal to 5 by 2. 5 by 2 is equal to 2.5. okay, so this is your h by 2 is 2.5. this h by 2 you will subtract from the this and you will add here. Okay, you will you will add here also and here also. You will subtract once here. Now here see, one time it is given and one time only. Here class intervals are not given. So your first interval will be 75 minus 2.5 and 75 plus 2.5. 75 minus 2.5 will be 72.5. 2. 75 plus 2.5 will be 77.5. Okay, so this will be your first class interval. Now what is there? 80. From 80 we need to subtract 2.5. 80 minus 2.5 will be 77.5. And 80 plus 2.5 means 82.5. This is your second interval. Then next one is 85. Okay, 85 minus 2.5 will be, again you will get 82.5. 85 plus 2.5 will be 87.5. Then next is 90. 90 minus 2.5, again you will get this 87.5. And 90 plus 2.5 means 92.5. Okay, then 95. Next is 95. 95 minus 2.5, 92.5. 95 plus 2.5 will be 97.5. Okay, and last class interval is 100. Okay, 100 minus 2.5 will be 97.5. 200 plus 2.5 will be 102.5. These are your class intervals, new class intervals, okay, which are continued because we want to prepare here histograms. Okay, so now you need to write here, the information is given 7, 11, 25, 7, 11, 7, 11, 25, 13, 6 and 3. So for this information you need to construct the histogram. Okay, so how we can construct the histogram? See here, again the same procedure we will do. Here information is there with you. So now you will need one y-axis, okay, and a x-axis. Understood? So our highest reading, first we need to think about this 7 11 25 30 6 and 3. Last one is 25 and minimum is 3. Okay, so we can go 0 1 2 3, means 0 to 3, 3 to 6, like that also we can go. That we can show easily. So this is 0, okay. This is, we can say 3, suppose we will take here 3, 6, then 3, 6, 9, 15, 18, 21, 24 and 27. Okay, now here we need to take king, because our intervals are going to start from 72.5. so here we will take jag line, okay, or king also we can say. So first interval we can take 72.5 to what is going to come 77.5. okay, then 82.5 to 87.5, then 92.5 to 102.5. okay, like that. Now classes are continue. Understood? Okay, now see, 72.5, this will come once. Then 82.5, this is going to come once. Then 87.5, this is going to come once. This will come once. And this is going to come once. Okay, this is going to come. And last one will be this. Okay, so . 72, 77, 82, 87, 92, then our 92, after 92, 97 is remaining. So here it will come 97.5, okay, and then 102.5. okay, like that class intervals are going to come. Okay, so now here 97.5. so just now we have to construct the bar graphs. So first one is reading, first one is 7, 7, 11, 25, 7 means it will come here, 6, 6, 7, 8, 6 here it is given. See, in between there 10 lines are there, understood? And numbers, how many numbers are there? 7 and 8, 2 numbers are there. Okay, so approximately we can take here and we can construct here bar graph, histogram. So it will come like this. Third one line, so it will come here. Third one line, so you will get here. Okay, like that you need to construct the whole histogram. So complete this question in your graph notebook. Thank you.